Donovan and Austin Idol of.
The song, the music, the Fantasia has entered the building. Gordon Solie, you must be delirious today. For some reason, I don't know why you or the people out here in Georgia Championship Wrestling or the people across the country think for 1 minute that we're going to disgrace and embarrass ourselves by coming out here and wrestling Austin Idol or Austin Ivan, whatever his name, and the little punk that we annihilated a couple weeks ago, why he wasn't here last week on television. Now look, wait a minute. We've got a contract, am I right, to wrestle another team, has more class, is tougher, and has more caliber than any Austin Idol or Kevin Sullivan could ever muster up to wrestle the Fabulous Freebirds.
Well, I'm sure that you could get that contract vacated and...
What? We don't break... Listen, do you know why we have integrity? Why we have respect all over the country? It's because we keep in our contractual agreements, so we're not breaking nothing for Kevin Sullivan or Austin Idol. Now, Sullivan, he must be a little bit insane after what we did the last time for what... Hey, what's this?
Me. Last week you said you wrestled me and I. Come on.
And
if I have to stoop low enough to take this man as my partner.
Wait a minute. Listen, we aren't scared to wrestle Austin Idol or anything, or Kevin Sullivan. Austin Idol's nothing but a cheap imitation of the Fabulous Freebirds. He wishes he was one. He is not the most beautiful, sexiest man in wrestling. I am. These are the greatest wrestlers in wrestling. Kevin Sullivan, we'll wrestle you and another partner. But Austin Idol can forget it because he doesn't deserve the privilege to get in the ring with the Fabulous Freebirds, and that's all.
Well, that's interesting. We'll find out more about that later on. Talking about finding out.
Totally, since we've come here, the ratings of this show have just increased and increased. I mean, more people are watching us than anything. More people are watching us than Charlie's Angels, than Vegas. More people are watching us than Luke and Laura on General Hospital. I mean, we are the talk of the country. Freebird Fantasia is sweeping the country, and Idol Mania is nothing but a bunch of goofs such as the lead ring himself, Austin Idol.
Wait a minute, he had him for the pin, but Michael went over there and said, pull him up, don't pin him. They bring him up again, full body slam. Terry off the ropes. Catches Turner again. And he's telling him again not to pin him. And it is Michael delivering all sorts of directives there. Turner brought up. Vertical suplex. A count of three. A count of three, and it is all over for Marvin Turner and Gerald Pitt. Wait a minute! Kevin Sullivan in there against all of them at one time. And it is Kevin... Now, wait a second. Austin Idol has just charged the ring along with Kevin Sullivan. Austin Idol and Kevin Sullivan. And the Freebirds are leaving.
We're on the scene. Where? What's happening? Did you see what happened? Did you see us get attacked from behind? I've been around longer than these boys, and I've never seen anything so ridiculous in my life. Let me tell you something, Austin Idol and Kevin Sullivan. Let me tell you, you did not impress us at all. You just made us mad, baby.
Hey, Gordon Solie, what they did only substantiates what I said to begin with. That Austin Idol talking about imitated and duplicated, he's nothing but a little packet of Kool-Aid as far as I'm concerned. He is nothing compared to us, me, or any of the Freebirds, and he does not have the class or the integrity to get in the ring with us because like a low-down dog he is, he jumped in and jumped us from behind, Gordon Solie.
Well, and that was needless abuse of that competitor. You already had him beat. You kept on encouraging your men. I think, frankly...
Hey, look, a lot of people have been getting hurt by the Fabulous Freebirds in here, and I said it before. If you don't want to get hurt, don't sign a contract to get in there. If you're not a man like we are, the kind of men that we are, then don't step in there. And I got one other thing to say. These people out here at Austin Idol had the audacity to call us jailbirds. We are upstanding citizens. We have never, ever been in jail. We are an upgrade to the community, and I appall The mere fact that you would approve and condone something so ridiculous as such.
I hardly have the right to try and control the emotions or the feelings of the fans who are here today.
Control? You're urging it on, Gordon Solie. No,
I beg to differ with you. Let's get right down to the basics of things. You have signed a contract. The Freebirds putting the Georgia Tag Team Championship on the line November 14th against Kevin Sullivan and
Gordon
Austin.
Gordon Solie, wait just a second. Please shut up. You get on my nerves sometimes, man. All I want to say is this. You know Kevin Sullivan and what's this geek's name, this bleach blonde Austin Idol? They come out here running their mouth, baby. They call us names. Let me tell you something. You ain't got no right calling us names, boy. And you're going to pay for it right here in Nominee. If you don't pay for it in Marietta tomorrow night, baby, we're going to get your hide. You can just a minute. Wait just a second, all right? Is my ears deceiving me, man? Did I really hear what I heard when I was sitting back in the monitor listening to Kevin Sullivan out here? You mean this man, he wants to get out here and he wants to challenge us right here on TV, man, and let us pick the partner?
Yeah, that's right. In fact, I have the contract right here.
Hey, it's obvious that this Kevin Sullivan, what few brains he did have, we knocked him right out of his ear.
Wait a minute. Let me see this. Let me see the contract, Sully. Because I know you and the kind of shenanigans. Let's see. The NWA here signs this contract. Freebirds, television match, Kevin Sullivan. Opponent to be named. The referee to be signed by Georgia Championship Wrestling, governed by Georgia Championship. Well, that's the same contract we always sign. Well, let us think it over, okay? We're going to look it over. If Kevin Sullivan wants to get embarrassed and humiliated right here, then that's just what you're going to get, boy, a present from Freebird Fantasia. Well, just let us, you know, dwell it over.
Dwell it over.
Where's in this contract, as you can see, the opponent that we are going to name, and first of all, I want to tell you there's a few changes. We're not going to wrestle them here today because all you people across the country, you millions of fans that need the opportunity to watch the fabulous Freebirds on national TV humiliate and annihilate Kevin Sullivan because he's a no-good hoodlum who steals hubcaps. I want you to tell everybody, get your daddy out of the field, get your mama out of the kitchen, you get your brother and sister out on the fields playing with the lambs and the sheeps. I want everybody out here next week. TV will be on 1 hour early, 5 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Central, and that'll be the end of Kevin Sullivan. Now, your partner shall be Mike Davis, boy, and you better, and not only that, listen to this, an added thing, a gift from our hearts. We are also going to put up the Georgia Tag Team Championship right here. That's right. We'll put up the belts, the national tag team titles right here next week, 5 o'clock Eastern, 1 hour earlier. Don't miss it because we're going to show this punk just what he's worth because I personally don't...
Well, indeed, a situation here. Wait a minute, here comes Kevin Sullivan.
Next week, boys.
Hey, Sissy, can I look at this for a second? Let me ask you one thing. You've given me Mike Davis as a partner, right? Next week, for sure.
1 hour earlier.
Next week, for sure.
That's right.
And you... All right.
Put up the Georgia title.
You know, you jailbirds are really more stupid. You're a lot stupider than I thought. Because you're going to put up the belts next week?
We're going to give you every chance to show yourself and humiliate you right here, boy.
Well, let me just read this last thing. It says, the referee to be signed by Georgia Championship Wrestling, right?
Well, what? All he's going to do is count your shoulders down. I mean,
he can read.
Well, he can read.
Well, there is a special referee, and he's going to be here right now. Can you come in a minute? I got a special referee.
Came to me during the commercial break.
Gordon, I hate to ask anybody for a favor, but I'm going to have to ask a favor here. I just would like to wait a few more minutes because Idol hasn't shown up yet, but I know he'll be here, so I'd like to get some time and wait for him to get here.
Well, this is a little unusual. Obviously, we have a situation here. Of course, it was signed that Austin Idol would be the special referee for this match. I can understand your reluctance to...
Hey, listen, Park A. Don't be coming up with no excuses. Why don't you just get up in the ring and take your whooping like the man that you're supposed to be?
Hey, one second. You've been asking for it all week. You know that. How come you're trying to prolong this? Get it on and get in the ring right now, boy.
Well, I told Gordon, Ida lives in here, and I know he's going to be here. So just give me a couple of minutes, and Davis and I will be here when I don't see up there.
Well, that's plenty of time here.
Wait a minute. You want a little bit more time? You want... Hey, wait. We got all day. We're the national champions. Hey, we'll give him a little bit more time. It's just prolonging the agony, but we'll give you a little bit more time. Okay, just a little bit.
Well...
Look, when are you going to wise up, boy? You've been had. Austin Idol is not going to be here.
The man told me he'd be here. He's going to be here. Just give me a little more time. That's all I want is a little more time.
Oh, okay, I didn't want to do this. I mean, it's bad enough we're going to beat you in the ring. I've got here a telegram sent to me by one Austin Idol, and I'll read this to you very plainly because I doubt you guys could read. To the Freebirds, sorry for the way I've treated you. I won't interfere with any of your matches anymore. Signed, Austin Idol. Now, wait a second. Let me reiterate back, and for those that don't know what reiterate means, let me backtrack. About 6 or 7 months ago, Austin Idol sent an application because he wanted to be a fabulous Freebird, and we thought it was a joke. We turned him down. He took it as an insult. That's why he came out here last week. That's why he wanted to be your special referee. But the man, at least he realized his error, wised up, and got out before it was too late. Now, boy, he's not going to be here today. He's not going to be your partner at any time. He's not going to be in any matches. You are alone, so get you and Mike Davis out there, and let's get it over with.
I'll tell you what, the man's going to be here because I believe in the man. The man gave me his word, and he'll be here. All I want is a little more time.
How hard are you, man? Look, here it is. Read it for yourself.
I read it. I'll tell you something. Not be here.
Freebird Fantasia. You know, Gordon Sully, let me get over here so we can get all of our beautiful bodies in there. You really can't blame a man because it takes a big man to realize when he's made a mistake and own up to it. And the man has saved himself so much embarrassment that's going to come down on Kevin Sullivan. So much humiliation that's going to come down on Kevin Sullivan. So I would say that the man made a very smart move, Gordon Sully. I would definitely say that he made a smart move by sending a telegram and realizing the ways of his errors of his ways, and not show up today.
Well, I'm faced with another problem now because Friday night, Austin Idol and Kevin Sullivan.
That's right. Wait just a second, Gordon.
That's at the Omni.
You forgot about tonight in Griffin, baby. We're going to be getting down tonight in Griffin and then tomorrow night in Marietta. But the Omni, it don't look like that Kevin Sullivan, or ever what his name is going to have a partner. But you know, I heard Jack Briscoe out here shooting his mouth off, man, saying he'd give him a hand. Well, let me tell you something, Jack Briscoe. You're going to have to get through me first, boy. And that's going to be hard to do. You can bet your money on it, baby.
We still have the problem that Mr. Austin Idol, to my knowledge, has not yet arrived, and so we still have this problem regarding the Georgia Tag Team Championship match scheduled to take place between the Freebirds, Kevin Sullivan, and Mike Davis. But Austin Idol was signed as the special referee for that.
Gordon, this thing is getting monotonous. Now, we had millions of fans across the country waiting all week to see this, and now the procrastination is beginning to get under my skin. Now, if Sullivan doesn't realize what is going on, then he's just as stupid as he looks. The guy sent the telegram. He realized his error, and he wanted to apologize and save himself humiliation. He's not going to be here. Let's get the match. Hey, come here, man. Hey. Come here. Look, he's not going to be here. Now, this is getting monotonous. Let's get it on.
Hey, Gordon, the man gave me his word he'll be here. Just like a few more minutes and he'll be here.
How stupid are you? He's not going to be here.
Gordon, I'd like to wait a few more minutes. Gordon, I'll tell you one thing. The man gave me his word that he'll be here. I believe in the man. I believe he'll be here. All I want is a few more minutes.
All right. That certainly seems... plausible enough. Let me just mention while we do have a second here, May I just mention that a very, very difficult situation because Kevin Sullivan is here, Mike Davis is here. I still don't see Austin Idol.
Well, Gordon, I know you're running short in time, but I know the man's going to be here. The man promised me, the man gave me his word. And
yeah, but there was a telegram that he sent the Freebirds.
Gordon, all I want the man to do is tell me face to face that he isn't going to be here. And I believe in the man. I know the man's going to be here.
Well, all right. You say he's going to be here. I don't see him. And knowing his character, knowing the kind of person he's been, you know, I still, frankly, in my opinion, I sort of doubt it.
Well, Gordon, let me tell you what. A lot of people doubt a lot of things, and I've doubted a lot of people my time, but one thing I don't doubt is when Austin Idol gave me his word, that is a bond. That's a man's bond when they give you his word. If Idol wasn't going to be here, he would have told me, and I'm not going to believe his...
your tail between your legs and get out of here. You want the match, it's now or never. There's millions of fans waiting. Now get in there and get your whooping.
Well, I'll tell you what. Okay, we don't have to wait. Me and Mike are going to do the job, and they're going to get the whooping they deserve.
Well, all right, I'll tell you what. I'll give you a couple of moments to get ready. Let's
call a 30-minute time limit.
And they have not even waited for the introduction. The battle is on. All four of them in the ring at the same time. Sullivan battling against Buddy and Terry at the same time. And it was Buddy being caught by Terry, and now Kevin Sullivan explodes. The Georgia Tag Team Championship on the line. Austin Idol did not appear. Austin Idol has not appeared. He was to be the special referee. It's Terry Gordy now against Kevin Sullivan. Remember, Mike Davis and Kevin Sullivan going for the Georgia Tag Team Championship. This match is one fall, a 30-minute time limit. In the event that we have to go to a commercial, should anything happen during that commercial, we will bring it back to you on instant replay. Should a pinfall or a submission occur? And it's Buddy... and Kevin Sullivan. And you can hear the chant by the crowd here at the Channel 17 Sports Arena. Jailbirds, jailbirds, jailbirds. But they are the Georgia Tag Team Champions, Kevin Sullivan in the black and gold trunks. The Boston Battler, who had counted on Austin Idol to be the special referee for this match. Sir, it was not made. It was not made. Mike Davis back outside the ring once again. And once again, joining me here at ringside, former World Heavyweight Champion Jack Bristol.
Well, I've been watching this here, boys, and Sullivan and Davis are sure wrestling above their ability today. The Idol not showing up, you know, and they want this match bad, and they're certainly wrestling above their normal capability.
Well, I guess, Jack, of course, that's true, I guess, in almost any sport like Mississippi and Alabama.
Well, that's true, Gordon. You know, it's just whoever wants it bad, and, you know, Mississippi State wanted out Alabama. It's the same way with Sullivan and Davis here. They want these three birds, and you can see, boy, they're giving them all they can handle.
And then some. Mike Davis, a near fall. Terry Gordon now takes him down to the beautiful arm drag. Gordy back on his feet.
Davis, I've never seen Davis look this good. But he's got that big Terry on the run right now.
Down to the lateral press. Terry Gordy powers out. Mike Davis back on his feet. Another arm drag takedown by Mike Davis. And you're exactly right, Jack. That adrenaline is really flowing in those two.
Davis look out of him go now, man.
Terry
sees that determined look on his face.
Kevin Sullivan giving it everything he's got, makes the tag once again. And a beautiful backdrop. And Mike Davis had made the tag and is in there. Mike Davis back out there now against Buddy. Another arm drag takedown. Makes the tag with Kevin Sullivan, the Boston Battler. Remember now, the Georgia Tag Team Championship on the line.
Working on experience tag team combination, boy. They got the tags down in and out of there together, just really doing a job on these guys.
We are indeed. I was talking to Kevin before the program began, and he was telling me that he and Mike have been working out religiously each and every day, and it apparently, at this point in time, Jack, their strategy is paying off.
No doubt about it, Gordon. This is excellent moves, and boy, their strategy of tagging in and out is just working really good for them. It's keeping them on top of the action all the time.
Good move by Mike Davis that time. The tag was made, and Buddy making his move now. Blocked by Davis. Beautiful block by Davis. And boy, what a combination. What a combination. And we might see the tide of the battle turning here. We may have to be cutting away, but let's hold on to this action. Let's hold on to this action. The tag is made again. Getting a signal here to cut away to a commercial, but let's hold on to that action if we can, please. If anything happens when we do have to go to a commercial, should a pinfall or a submission occur, we'll be sure and bring it to you on an instant replay. But we're apparently going to have to go to a commercial. Buddy in trouble here as Kevin Sullivan continues to dominate the situation. And they are going for it. We'll be back in just a moment. Falls by Kevin Sullivan and Mike Davis in a remarkable showing here against the Georgia tag team champions, the Freebirds. Good move by Davis in behind his man once again. Davis breaking free, and I'll tell you what, we've got some great action going here. And if I were to judge this match on points thus far, I would have to Mike Davis and Kevin Sullivan. They have really been firing away. There you go. That could be it. One, two. No, sir. Beautiful move by Mike Davis, an inside cradle. And now Kevin Sullivan, the Boston battler, moves back in. And Sullivan dominating the situation here. And Michael Hayes, the spokesman for the Freebirds, must have some panic racing. Beautiful double teaming there before the count of four. Again, the lateral press, but again, Buddy is able to power out before the count of three. Mike Davis moves in again. A roundhouse right that catches him back of the ear. Buddy brings him up. No, sir, Mike Davis. Thought for a moment Mike Davis had that pinning combination. The tag is made. Terry Gordy moves in. Is made. Kevin Sullivan back into the ring. Terry Gordy with a snapmare makes the tag with Buddy. There you can see. Michael issuing instructions. And he has room to be panicked here. He has room to be panicked because Kevin Sullivan and Mike Davis have really been pouring on the scene. There you see some double teaming now. Terry Gordy unleashing with everything he's got. Kevin Sullivan powered back, comes up a rolling tag with Mike Davis. Mike Davis moves out there. Arm whips this man up. High backdrop by Mike Davis and Gordy. Those eyes turn skyward momentarily. Davis brings up a full body slam. Mike Davis comes down with the elbow. Gordy rolled out of the way just in time. Tag is made. Buddy moves in. Catches him on the side of the head. Davis trying to get over to tag up. Into the backbreaker. Mike Davis caught in that backbreaker. And it's Davis being caught again. And Davis beginning to show the wear of this tremendous match. And remember, Davis is trying to get over to tag up. Sullivan is caught. Sullivan is charging back in the ring, blocked by the referee. Double team momentarily has him up. Ooh! Variation of the pile driver. A count of three. May I just say that that was well within the four count.
Hey, Terry, buddy, listen. After wrestling that trash, go take the belt, go take a shower, polish the belt, clean up, okay? Now, see,
This is no surprise to me whatsoever, Sully. I knew this was going to happen. But, Sullivan, that kid is hurt because of you. He came out here and tried his hardest because you didn't have the guts to get in there and take the whooping. That's why he's hurt.
Satisfied.
That's what he got. That little punk came out here for 2 weeks stating he wanted the fabulous Freebirds. Then he let a young kid who got out here on national TV and tried his hardest for a chance at the national tag team title. And here he comes.
I saw Austin Idol. He's here. I saw Austin Idol. He's here. He's here right now.
What do you mean, Austin Idol?
I saw Austin Idol.
Well, fine. If you can get him, I'd sure like to talk to him. Frankly, that you'd show your face here now after what's happened.
Sure, I'm showing my face. All the pretty women out there want to see this beautiful, gorgeous, sexy face. That's what I'm going to show my face.
Yeah, well, the match has already taken place.
What do you mean?
Well, you were late. You were late. We've been waiting for you.
Well, I might be a couple minutes late because I had to change the flat tire. But it doesn't make any difference. I'm here now, so let's get this thing going. Come on. What do you mean the match is taking place?
Hey, I already told him about the telegram, boy. You're wasting your breath. I done told him about it, baby.
I read the telegram. I read the telegram that you sent to the Freebirds saying that you weren't going to be here. And now you tell me you had a flat tire.
What telegram you told him about?
Telegram that he brought out saying that you apologized, that you had once wanted to be a Freebird.
I once wanted to be a Freebird? Well, you got to be ribbing me, Sully. Me want to be a Freebird? That's like saying Ronald Reagan would want to be John Anderson. I would want to be a Freebird. Hey, I'm the golden boy of wrestling.
Boy, we wouldn't want you as a Freebird because we don't have scum like you. Now, Sullivan just got hurt, and I guess it probably would take some time to change 4 flat tires, but the boy just got a whooping.
Wait a minute. What did you say?
I said if you don't want to get the same whooping he got on national TV.
No. Wait a minute. What did you say before you said that? What did you say before that?
I didn't say nothing. I just...
No. What did you say about 4 flat tires? How did you know that I had 4 flat tires?
Well, you just come out here and said you had a flat tire.
No, I said, yes, right. I said I had a flat tire. I didn't say nothing about having 4 flat tires. Well, you dirty stinker.
Wait a minute. Hey. Wow, Austin Idol after him now. And we've got to get some order restored. Apparently, the Freebirds must have flattened the tires on Austin Idol's car to make sure that he would not get here. Ooh, caught him with a steel chair. And Austin Idol. Here by the Freebirds. Idol trying to battle his way back to his feet. But wait just a moment. Just a second. Kevin Sullivan is back in action. And it is Austin Idol and Kevin Sullivan battling the 3 Freebirds and Sullivan pounding away. It is now they've got Buddy out of there. Terry is out of it trying to regain his senses. Kevin
baby.
Move it. Memorial Auditorium, you'll have a great card. When you get to Columbus, Ohio, they'll love you. That's the Ohio Center. The Freebirds will be there with you. And don't forget Christmas night, Atlanta. Thank you.
Just go on. Listen, I don't know what is the matter with Paul Jones, if he's gone senile or lost his brain, putting a money match like this that would fill any arena in the country on TV. But there's one out, and we're going to prove it. If they lose, they got to pack their bag and get out. And that's just what you better do, is pack your bag, because you're fixing to get out of here.
We're going to find out. Let's turn it over to the ring.
I'm tired of people pushing us around.
Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team event for the Georgia Tag Team Championship with a TV time limit. Introducing first at a combined weight of 740 pounds, the tag team champions, Michael Terry and Buddy, the Fabulous Freebirds. Their opponents, Robert Fuller and Stan Frazier.
All right, Robert Fuller and Stan Frazier, I've asked Ted DiBiase to join me here. Very, very little time remaining and a very critical match.
Well, here it is, Gordon. You know, I saw Robert Fuller, and as I expressed earlier in the show, they're fired up about this match. To go ahead and say they didn't care if they lost, that's quite a statement after only being here a couple weeks. And Robert Fuller is ready for battle right now.
And Fuller now taking a lot of punishment. Terry tags up with Buddy, and so the Freebirds trying to dominate. Fuller battered back against those ropes, and it's Buddy continuing to issue more and more punishment, and it is Robert Fuller outside the ring. Outside the ring on this concrete floor. And big Stan Frazier moving down out of his corner.
You know, Gordon, these Freebirds, you know, I've been here for a few weeks now, and I've sat by and I've just watched. I haven't really voiced my opinion, but I know the Freebirds. I've wrestled them before. I wrestled them all over Louisiana and Mississippi. The threat is always that third man. You never know when he's going to be there, and you can always count on him being there. He's always going to present himself. That's the threat today. That's what I'm worried about, is that third man is going to stick his nose in that ring when the action gets... There's that big Stan Frazier. He's got Michael.
Now we've got Frazier crashing down. Buddy rolled out of the way just in time, and now Buddy trying to pound away on him.
Well, I don't care what you say about Stan Frazier. He might be big and overweight, but it's like you say, you know, where's a 400-pound gorilla sleep, Gordon? Anywhere he wants to, and you get that man riled up, and he can do a lot of damage.
Certainly no question about that, and this match continues, and time continues. And it is Buddy crashing an elbow into Stan Frazier, and again, Frazier uncorking against him, and now makes the tag with Robert Fuller. Robert Fuller comes charging in. Robert Fuller has Buddy and Terry Gordy in there. Now we've got all four of them in the ring. All four in the ring, and it is...
Anything can happen now, Gordon, all four in this man. That referee's got a hard job trying to control a match like this. Of course, the Freebirds want to keep the titles, and there's Michael Hayes.
He's got the Fuller leg lock.
That's what I was talking about. You always got... Gordon, I said I wanted to help him out, and I'm going to right now.
Robert Fuller had him in the Fuller leg lock, and our time is rapidly disappearing here. Ted DiBiase has charged the ring after Michael Hayes, and wait a second. Here comes Kevin Sullivan. Everybody charging in there. Our time is gone.
Together. They got 30 years of obvious solid wrestling knowledge. The way, Michael, the way you pinned that man just now, you were fantastic.
It was nothing, thank you. I just would like to say, Gordon Solie, for those out there that aren't brain surgeons, take a minute to think about it. That was not an elimination tag. What would have happened if we'd have got rid of the other two first before we got to Jimmy Jones? That's something that Robert Fuller has to think about. That's something that Stan Frazier and I promise. And when I make a promise and they make a promise, we keep it. DiBiase, let me tell you something, boy. You know what we've done before. You push us too far, and we will do it again. And I am sadly afraid that you have pushed us too far.
Well, may I just take a moment, if I may, to talk a little bit about Georgia Tag Team Champions. And once again, you hear the music that signifies and denotes their presence. But a lot of people are very, very distressed about this combination.
You know something, Gordon Solie? At this time, I'd like to wish all our family and our few friends that we have around the country a Merry Christmas. Because, you know, this is supposed to be a joyful and happy occasion, happy time of the year. But I have to admit that I am not that happy right now. I do not feel that well. As a matter of fact, I'm disturbed, and I'll tell you why. when we first started this thing with Terry and I, and we whooped people in Tennessee, they said you can't do it in Georgia. We went on and we whooped people in Kentucky, and they said you can't do it in Georgia. Then we picked up Buddy in Mississippi and Louisiana and broke every attendance record that they ever had there for years and years, including the Louisiana Superdome, and they said you can't do it in Georgia. So what did we do? We packed up our things and we came to Georgia. And the first thing we did was beat Wrestling 1 and 2 for the Georgia Tag Team title, and one of the reasons Wrestling 2 retired. We ran Austin Idol out of here as quick as he came in. And then we beat all the top teams in the country to become the national tag champions. And what do we get for it? Nothing. Not one bit of respect. When we walk in the arenas, you can't even get our names right. It's not Jailbirds, it's Freebirds. And my name is Michael, and it is not Michelle. Michael happens to be the top name for men in the country today. It's the number one name. And let me tell you something, baby, I am all man. I am 240 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal. And for anybody to think otherwise humiliates me and it makes me mad. But you know the whole reason for this? It's because they're all jealous of the way I look. Look, it's not my fault that I have beautiful hair or a beautiful face or a sensuous body. It's not my fault when your women lay down at night to sleep that they have me on their mind and wake up in the morning with me. And it is not my fault for the things that happen.
Well, let me just say something. You know, you're doing all of this talking. However, you do all the talking, they do all the wrestling. Every time I see you, you're either jumping in the ring illegally, you're never there by yourself.
Now, wait a minute. Now, that's what gets me mad. People are saying that I don't live up to my third of the Fabulous Freebirds, right? Well, you've been out here hammering and clattering for weeks and weeks that Ted DiBiase is the number one guy to take Harley Race's belt. All the sports writers, all the critics, right? Am I right? I tell you what. If he's got any guts and he's got any confidence in his national title, I will wrestle him right here on TV today in a single match, DiBiase, and beat you and humiliate you and start an elimination.